Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Muhammad Ali Jinnah was a barrister, politician, and the founder of Pakistan. Jinnah served as the leader of the All India Muslim League from the 1913 until Pakistan's creation on the 14th August 1947 and then as Pakistan's first Governor General until his death. He is revered in Pakistan as Qaid-e-Azam, a great leader, and Baba-e-Qaum, father of the nation. 14th August 1947 to 11th September 1948. Liaquat Ali Khan, position established. Khwaja Nizamuddin. 11th August 1947 to 11th September 1948. Maulvi Tamizuddin Khan, position established. Maulvi Tamizuddin Khan. 11th August 1947 to 11th September 1948. Liaquat Ali Khan, office created, office abolished. Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was born on 25th December 1876 in Karachi. 11th September 1948, age 71. Mazar-e-Qaid, British Indian 1876 to 1947, Pakistani 1947 to 1948, Muslim League, Indian National Congress 1906 to 1920 and All India Muslim League 1913 to 1947, Imibai Jinnah and Ratan Bai, Deena Wadia, barrister and politician. Signature. Born at Wazir Mansion in Karachi, Jinnah was trained as a barrister at Lincoln's in London. Upon his return to British India, he enrolled at the Bombay High Court and took his interest national politics, which eventually replaced his legal practice. Jinnah rose to prominence in the Indian National Congress in the first two decades of the 20th century. In these early years of his political career, he advocated Hindu-Muslim unity, helping to shape the 1916 Lucknow Pact between the Congress and All India Muslim League, in which Jinnah had also become prominent. By 1940, Jinnah had come to believe that the Muslim of the Indian subcontinent should own state. In that year, Muslim led by Jinnah passed the Lahore Resolution demanding a separate nation. As the first Governor General of Pakistan, Jinnah worked to establish and policies and to aid the immigrated from the new nation of India to Pakistan. After independence, personally supervising the establishment of refugees camps. Jinnah's given name at birth was Muhammad Ali Jinnah, and he likely was born in 1876 to Jinnah, Punja Jinnah and his wife Mithi Bai in a rented apartment on the second floor of Wazir Mansion near Karachi, now in Sindh, Pakistan, but then in the Mumbai Presidency of British India. Jinnah's family was Gujarati, Khoja Shia's Muslim background through Jinnah later followed the 12 Shia's teachings. After his death, his relative and other witness claimed that he had converted life to the Sunniest sect. His religion at the time of his death was disputed in multiple court cases. Jinnah was from a wealthy merchant background. His father was a merchant and was born to a family of textile weavers in the village of Paneli in the Paisli, state of Gondal. His mother was also that village. They had moved to Karachi in 1875. Having married before their departure, Jinnah was the second child. He had three brothers and three sisters, including his younger sister Fatma Jinnah. The parents were native Gujarati speakers and the children also come to speak Gujarati, Kutchi and English. As a boy, Jinnah lived for a time in Mumbai with an aunt and may have attended the Gokal Das Tej Primary School there, later in studying at the Cathedral and John Cannon School. In Karachi, he attended the Sindh Madrasatul Islam and Christian Missionary Society High School. He gained his matriculation from Bombay University at the high school. In his later years, and especially after his death, a large number of stories about the boyhood of Pakistan's founder were circulated. There he spent all his spare time at the police court listening to the proceedings, and that he studied his books by the glow of street lights for lack of the other illumination. His official biographer Hector Bolito, writing in 1945, interviewed surviving boyhood Dinar discourages other children from playing marbles in the dust, keep their hands and clothes clean and play cricket instead. Ali Jinnah was the first cousin and wife of the founder of Pakistan, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, from 1892 until her death. Muhammad Ali Jinnah, 1892 to 1893.
Ratan Bai Jinnah.
She was the wife of Muhammad Ali Jinnah, an important figure in the creation of Pakistan and the country's founder. Muhammad Ali Jinnah, 1918 to 1929. Dina Wadia. Dina Wadia was the daughter and the only child of the founder of Pakistan, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, and his wife Ratan Bai. She belonged to the prominent Jinnah family through her father, the Patel family through her mother, and to the Wadia family through her marriage to Neville Wadia. In 1948, Jinnah returned to Quetta, but at the advice of doctors, soon journeyed to an even higher retreat at Zyarat. Jinnah had always been reluctant to undergo medical treatment, but realizing his condition was getting worse, the Pakistani government sent the best doctors it could find to treat him. Test confirmed tuberculosis and also show evidence of advanced lung cancer. He was treated with the new miracle drug of streptomycin, but it did not help. Jinnah's condition continued to deteriorate despite the Eid prayers of his people to the lower altitude of Quetta on 13th August, the eve of Independence Day, for which a goose written statement for him was released. Despite an increase in appetite, it was clear to his doctor that if he was to return to Karachi in life, he would have to do so very soon. Jinnah, however, was reluctant to go, not wishing his aides to see him as invalid on a stretcher. By 9 September, Jinnah had also developed pneumonia. Doctor urged him to return to Karachi where he could receive better care, and with his agreement, he was flown there on the morning of 11 September. Doctor Elahi was his personal physician. Believed that Jinnah's change of mind was caused by foreknowledge of death. The plane landed at Karachi that afternoon to be met by Jinnah's limousine and an ambulance, into which Jinnah's stretcher was placed. The ambulance broke down on the road into town, and the Governor General and those with him waited for another to arrive. He could not be placed in the car as he could not sit up. They waited by roadside in oppressive heat as trucks and buses passed by, unsuitable for transporting the dying man, and with their occupants not knowing of Jinnah's presence. After an hour, the replacement ambulance came and transported Jinnah to Government House. Jinnah died later that night at 10:20 p.m. at his home in Karachi on 11 September 1948 at age of 71. Just over a year after Pakistan's creation. Indian Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru stated upon Jinnah's death, "How shall we judge him? I have been very angry with him often during the past years, but now there is no bitterness in my thought of him, only a great sadness for all that has been. He succeeded in his quest and gained his objective, but at what cost, and with what a difference from what he had imagined." Jinnah was buried on 12 September 1948 amid official mourning on both India and Pakistan. A million people gathered for his funeral. Indian Governor General Raj Gopal Acharya cancelled an official reception that day in honor of the latter leader. Today, Jinnah rests in a large marble mausoleum, Mazar-e-Qaid in Karachi.